The flight deck of an aircraft carrier is the surface from which the fighter jets take off and land. Have you ever wondered, why are these floating airstrips always at an angle on the carrier and not straight? Are there any solid reasons behind this, or is this just a random design? What do you think? Let's find out. During the initial days of the aircraft carriers, when they had propeller-driven planes, they could either launch or land a plane at a time. Doing both at the same time wasn't possible. The runways were short, the planes could collide into each other trying to pull off landing and taking off at the same time. The propeller-driven planes were lightweight, slow, and thus were easy to stop, so small runways weren't much of a problem. But with the advent of sophisticated fighter jets, aircraft carriers needed longer landing strips, as they were heavy and pretty darn fast. They required a longer strip to land and stop. The angled deck, also known as the skewed, canted, or the waist angle deck, was invented by the Royal Navy. It was designed with high-speed fighter aircrafts in mind. Angled decks enabled jets to take off and land at the same time. In case during landing, if the jets failed to connect with the arrestor cables, they could abort landing, throttle up, and relaunch without the risk of ramming into another jet taking off at the same time. The angled flight deck was first tested in 1952 on HMS Triumph, later on USS Midway the same year. It also allowed more area for the other operations on the ship, and thus eventually became a defining feature of the aircraft carriers. Well guys, this is pretty much it. If you liked the episode, do hit that like button, share it with your friends, subscribe, hit the bell icon to be notified of the new content on the channel. This is Curious Planet signing off. Until next time.